My name is confronting with a political crisis. So, how is this affecting the Romanian telecom market or market telecommunication in general?
Is this a question you're asking me or a statement you're making?
No, it's a question. How is this affecting the telecom market?
Well, it should not affect telecom market. I mean, there's, regardless of which government is in place today worldwide, there's absolutely no way out of it. The path towards recovery is a path which must be based on the fact that ICT technology and the internet is leveled. So there is no other way to, you know, in which you have create economic opportunities for new companies, new startups, where the creativity of individuals, the innovation capability of companies cannot be assured without this. So I'm not going to make any comment on the situation in Romania because I simply don't know the details of it, but regardless of the government, there's no hope other than to invest on ICT and the internet of tomorrow. That's the way in which economic prosperity can be reached.
Romanian market still lags behind Western European broadband penetration rates. When do you think Romania can bridge the gap and close the developed market?
Well, Romania is not as bad as you may think. Romania is a very important market, particularly when it comes to software. It's one of the places in the world, I would say it's perhaps the second or third best place in the world when it comes to outsourcing of software. You have a very good educational regime which has ensured people have the competence to be able to act very well in the domain of software. So, talent exists. What it needs to be done now is to continue to leverage these talents into more economic opportunities. So it can be via broadband deployment, by wireless deployment, by fiber optics, by a combination of these. But I mean, there's no doubt that Romania has the potential to be ahead of what Europe is all about.
But can we hope in a decade to reach the same penetration rate of broadband as France or Northern Europe in Romania?
Yes, you can. I mean, but again, I mean, this is the comment I have just made at the very end. Mm-hmm. When you look at many countries in the world, they have no broadband whatsoever.
Yes.
And they have the chance to jump ahead one technology. And the technology of tomorrow is going to be wireless. So you don't need necessarily to put cable and fiber on the ground. You can do the same with wireless.
Yeah.
Today, there are technologies out there which are equally good than broadband to deliver the bit rates that you want to have for whatever application. So,
yes,
in terms of investment, it's a lot cheaper. I've indicated in my presentation that the cost of fiber to the home in Europe is estimated to be at least 250 billion euros across Europe. So this is a significant amount of money. If you do it via wireless, you jump ahead and you have the possibility to serve places quite rapidly. So when you say 10 years time, it can even be shorter if the right incentives are given to those who need to invest in wireless.
Yes.
Some countries made the internet fundamental law for human rights.
You're talking about Finland.
Yeah.
You're talking about Finland. Finland has declared it to be a legal right. Yes, that's. I think this is an extremely good measure. There are many other countries in Europe where people are considering this. France is also considering that.
Mm-hmm.
It will take some time before people become conscious of the fact that this is indeed, it's like any other right that we may have as citizens. I mean, you cannot be deprived nowadays of access to the information society. So I personally think it's a very good gesture now. Politically and from a regulatory point of view, it will take some time before this is done. Don't forget that Finland has been ahead of Europe in terms of deployment of wireless and wire for a long time. Mm-hmm. You know, one of the most aggressive, innovative countries.
But what do you think is the trend? To have free internet in the future in the cities and to pay only if you want a high data connection, and everybody to have free internet in the, or at least in the city. Will we reach to that?
Well, I mean, if you say free internet, Wi-Fi, mm-hmm. that's one story. But Wi-Fi is limited in terms of capacity. Mm-hmm. That's why people invest in fiber. But yes. fiber is expensive. You have to dig the road, you have to, it's expensive. So it's not, it doesn't come for free. So I don't believe that there will be ever a situation where these sort of services are free. Mm-hmm. They are need to be provided against a return, a reasonable return on investment.
So it's just
not expect anyone to invest just for fun.
So it's just an utopia to think that in a day we'll have free internet and we'll pay
you
only.
You will have free internet here and there yes. in areas like, for instance, if downtown Bucharest, you have uh-huh. Wi-Fi.
But not at home for everybody.
But to have it at home and to have it worldwide enough to cover 100% of the population, this is utopia. To think that this is going to be done in the next few years. It may take time.
Yes.
Hopefully,
yes.
we'll get there.